You want answers? You want answers!
I want the truth!
You can't handle the truth!
And welcome to Tuesday Morning! I am your host, Justin Clark, protecting you from the hypocrisy of America. Together, we will bully the bullies. Today on the program, major, and I mean major, show news to announce. It will sadden some of you, maybe make some of you happy, but I doubt it. We'll get to that. Also, despite CDC guidelines and a moratorium on evictions, the White House evicted two over the last couple of days, despite the CDC banning evictions. And much more to get to. Quick housekeeping before we begin. I will be taking your calls and text messages. 321-339-1055. If you would like to watch the show, follow the Florida Man Radio Network Facebook page. You can watch right there. But a great show on the actual radio this morning. But first, the team to my right. Her hair is down. It is a sea blue dress with a white blouse. Queen Kayla is here. Hello, Kayla.
Hello.
Directly in front of me, fresh off a non-vacation day off, he is wearing a nice pressed Nike green t-shirt. Lurch, greetings.
Greetings.
321-339-1055.
And now it's time for the opening statement. This should be interesting.
Something has been brewing around here for a while. I got a call. It was a Sunday night, I believe, from Lurch. He's like, we need to talk. It has to do with your show. Now, this was, I don't know, 3 or 4 weeks ago at this point. I've had to keep all this under wraps.
It was a Tuesday.
Whatever. Yeah, same thing. You know, Tuesday, Sunday. They're all the same. They all run together. And I was like, all right, when are you quitting? Basically. Because I've employed enough people over the years that I know when someone walks in my office, I say, when's your last day? I know the look on their face. And I can say exactly what they're about to tell me is, okay, we're quitting, putting in our two-week notice or whatever. I know immediately when someone walks into my office and it's the I'm quitting routine. So I know also tones of voice when it's I'm quitting. And I was like, okay, I didn't even say what's up. I said, why are you quitting? Where are you going? I like that. Taco Bell called. They offered an assistant GM with 10% off your food. What happened?
10%. What? No, so I called him, and well, no, actually, I think I messaged you. I said, we need to talk.
And I know I could tell by a text message what it means.
Immediately, this man called me. Yeah. What's going on? What? And then I said, well, we need to talk, but I'm going to go play soccer right now, so I'll talk to you after.
And nothing worse than that. Like, when Pilar does that to me, I will scream. That's the only time I get really pissed off. If it's like, I need to talk to you about something important. I'm like, all right, talk.
Right.
Well, I'm in the middle of something. No. F you. That is not how this game works.
I'm the same way.
No. Like, but anyway, saying. But you know, you're not my wife, so it's harder for me to be nasty with you. So I let you go play soccer, and you called me later. And I was like, all right, when are you quitting? And it's not that you're quitting the show. Yes. And by the way, as you might know, we are debuting in the Panhandle in the Fort Walton Beach Destin market less than 2 weeks from now.
Yes, we are.
And you know that. But the thing is, before we go on the air there, we were rebranding the show name from You Have Power Radio to the Justin Clark Show or whatever we decide.
Yeah, the Justin Clark Show.
And we needed a new logo for that. We needed a new logo for that. And so Brianna, when she was here, created the logo, and it had me, you, and Brianna on it. Then she quit. And then she created, before she left, the logo with me and you. Yeah. And then you, what I'm about to tell you is happening. I don't know if I can even put you in the logo. So now I got 3, 4, 5, 6 logos flying around, and I don't even know what the hell to do. I mean, I might as well put my dog at this point on the logo.
You and your three pets.
Yeah. So Lurch calls me back after playing soccer, and I say, when are you quitting?
Yeah, that's exactly. Is this that Lurch? Okay, when's your last day?
That's what I said,
not,
right?
Yeah, I'm not quitting.
When's your last day? And he said, well, it's not. By the way, I was at a party on Sunday night, and someone there was a fan of the show, and they wanted to be clear, is that your real voice? And I said, yes, it is his real voice, right?
Yes.
And he's like, no, it's not. I said, no, that's really Lurch's voice. So I defended you on
that. Wow. This man had my back.
Lurch tells me that he has always wanted to be in the United States military.
That is correct.
And he has always said that since I've known him. And despite the fact that he's, I don't know, pushing mid-30s, Lurch has decided to sign up and made it official yesterday. He is now property of the United States Army.
Reserves.
Okay.
Reserves.
Yeah, reserves.
And so, I made sure yesterday, too, I was like, it says reserve, right? It doesn't say.
Congratulations to you, Lurch. Now, what does that mean for the program, I guess, is what you're probably wondering. Are we going to hear from Lurch? Is he gonzo? And I think that's what we're going to work through this morning, basically. By the way, congratulations. Obviously, it's hard to criticize because it's not Taco Bell. had it been Taco Bell, we would be doing a whole other program
today. I'm not going to be the assistant manager, don't worry.
That being said, it's obviously a good thing that you want to go fight, support, whatever it is for your country. Now, what do the reserves actually do, though? The reserves more... Don't they show up when like a hurricane rolls through or something? No, I'm serious. I'm not trying to be a dick.
That's National Guard.
Oh, yeah, that's National Guard. So the reserves, though, what do you guys do?
I mean, pretty much I'm going to be doing the same job that I would be like in the military.
Yeah.
But if, let's say, hell breaks loose, then, I mean, we're going to. It's a part-time. That's what it is.
It's a part-time gig.
Yeah, it's a part-time. Once a month.
But what is not part-time is you will be departing from the radio station, at least temporarily, to go to...
Basic boot camp.
Then, so, like, that's the real... Can't you get, like, a mid-30s version of it?
No, and then
you tell them I'm not a 21-year-old pup anymore. You got to go to boot camp? Like the Full Metal Jacket boot camp?
So 9 weeks of basic training. I'm going to be in Fort Jackson, South Carolina. And then right after, I'm going to do 9 weeks of advanced individual training in Fort Leonard Wood, Missouri.
Wow. Now, is this the real deal basic training for real?
Yes,
I mean, like what the kids have to go through?
The real deal, yeah.
That you got to do pull-ups and everything?
Yeah, everything.
Oh, Jesus.
Everything. This is the real deal.
And you didn't allow me to discuss this for a while because I guess it wasn't official until yesterday.
To make it official because I didn't, like yesterday I went to MEPS to do the physical and do all that. I didn't want, let's say I went yesterday and then they're like, oh, we noticed a scar or something like that. No, well, I mean, they try to, like, disqualify you. So, like, any reason that they can have to, like, disqualify you, like, they'll do it. So I didn't want to go there and for something to happen and then I come back and, like, oh, yeah, I need to get a doctor's note for this or I need to get a doctor's note for that, which unfortunately did happen to...
They already kicked some people out. They're like, you're all set. We don't need you that badly.
Now, it's not a permanent. It's a temporary. So, meaning, like, they can work with you. We're like, okay, well... let's say this scar or something happened, whatever, we need document of when you went to the doctor.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh. I wonder what they'd say about me. Number one, I'm too old. What is the age limit to go join the Army Reserves?
I think it's 35.
And you're how old?
32.
32. So you're getting up there. I mean, in Army years. Were you the oldest dude there?
No, actually, there was another guy. He was 34.
Wow. So you guys are going to be best buddies.
That I know of. But, and, I mean, it's sad because some people got disqualified because they couldn't do, like, the duck walk. Or they couldn't, like, they didn't have, like, full range of motion.
What is the duck? Caleb wants to know what the duck walk is. What is that exactly? Show
me.
Just show it. Stand up. Like, dude, we have room. Show us the duck walk. He's doing the duck walk. Oh, that sucks.
Oh.
I would have been run right out of there after that one. This kid can't do the duck walk. Did you know what the duck walk was? No. Kayla didn't know either. I didn't know. I'm not going to lie to you. I didn't know what the duck walk was. So you go there and you have to do a whole, what do you do? A shuttle run? Like you go pick up the erasers?
No, they don't do that.
Do you do the 40?
No.
That's the NFL?
Yeah.
Oh. So what is it? So you show up in a room.
No. I mean, it's a full physical. When I say full physical, I mean, they check every nook and cranny in your body.
So you have to get almost naked in front of a bunch of dudes?
Oh, no, yeah. Well, not in front of a bunch of dudes, but you have to get pretty much naked in front of the doctor.
Yikes.
And then you're in the room. They do eight at a time with a bunch of other guys just in your boxers, and you're doing all these
Did you get a body mass index number?
No, I did not.
I'd like to compare it to mine.
Because I have mine. Remember, I got it from Body Street the other day.
They said they've seen worse.
So you passed yesterday.
Yes.
All right. Now you've passed, and I guess now you are officially part of the United States military.
Yes.
Now, are you getting free health insurance yet?
That I know of, not yet.
When does that kick in? Because that's pretty big.
I think May 18th when I ship out.
Oh, that so they May can't. 18th, they can't. Slip you a couple of free weeks or something. Like they can't start May 1st.
Well, but in the reserve,
when do you start getting paid?
In the reserve, I still have to pay for my health care.
What?
But it's ridiculously cheap.
Like how much per month would you say?
I'm going to say it's going to be like $42 a
month. $42. That's pretty good.
Which is, I mean, ridiculously cheap.
And we have this new VA in Orlando down in Lake Nona that everyone says is pretty good.
So the thing is, of course, it's all about trying to get a job, unfortunately, because in joining the reserve, it's literally slim pickings. Mm-hmm. Like whatever they have is whatever they have. And, of course, my whole deal is to be here in Orlando because I live in Orlando and I work in Orlando. So there was only one job available here in Orlando, which is a Seaburn specialist.
Hold on, time out. So when you sign up to join the Army Reserves, that you get to choose what job you're going to have
later?
Well,
yeah. They look at what jobs are available.
So you know for a fact that you will get this job in Orlando when you're done?
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
I have this job already.
What? Is that how it works in the regular military? You get to choose where you're going to be and what kind of job?
Well, the job will dictate where you'll be. So let's say like a job that I would really want is a geospatial imagery analyst.
Okay,
but the thing is,
whatever that is,
there wasn't any available. And if I was going to go active duty, then I mean, all these jobs would have. I mean, I did pretty good on the
Instead, though, you signed up to be what?
A Seaburn specialist, so a chemical, nuclear, and radiological specialist. Yes.
A chemical what?
Chemical, nuclear, and radiological specialist.
I mean, you know, it's scientific. What are you like testing out Gatorade bottles for the Snap show?
I'll be in hazmat suits, gas masks.
Really?
Yeah,
that's pretty sweet.
The whole deal.
I mean,
and then I'll be training people on how to like properly put on equipment and how to use equipment in case of.
Are those things air conditioned or not? Do you know the hazmat suits? Because it gets hot in Florida.
Yeah, I know.
So, all right, take me through this then. So you did your little pull up thing yesterday or whatever, and they allowed you to cut. You got in your underwear yesterday, and they said, okay, you signed up. You're part of the United States Army Reserves now.
Yes.
And now they're saying you're shipping out of here May 18th.
May 18th, correct.
So essentially it's a long funeral for us for the next 2 months, or what is it? I don't know. Because for the next 2 months, we got to talk about you're leaving. And then how long are you gone? I think that's the key. We need to figure out how long are you going to be gone.
So 9 weeks basic training.
Time out. Let me think through this a bit. So 9 weeks basic training. Like that's where they're yelling at you and slapping you around and whatnot, right?
Oh, slapping.
Now, do you think being an older dude that they'll give you more respect?
No.
No? Surely they will.
We're all equal. Yeah.
What if you tell them you're on the radio?
What does that mean?
Although a lot of people there yesterday at MEPS were, of course, everyone was like commenting about the voice. And, yeah, look at this guy. And I was like, yes, I'm a full-time radio host.
I mean,
I was popular.
I think you'll get more respect, don't you think so? I think they'll have respect because like, oh, you're on the radio.
I mean, yeah, but not at the end of the day. If I'm still equal to everyone else.
So you don't think being an older dude on the radio, they'll be nicer to you? Because like, I've seen Full Metal Jacket. Let me be honest with you. Okay, and that's really the only thing I compare it to, and that really looked like it sucked.
Oh.
And that was boot camp, wasn't it?
Yeah, it's boot camp.
So you're going to boot camp, like with the 19-year-old kids.
Yeah, 17-year-old.
What are you guys
going to
talk about? Are you going to be you roll in and be like, I know TikTok too.
Yeah.
I know this TikTok, right? Because then, I mean, that's the only way you get respect with the 19-year-olds, I think, is you're going to have to pretend like you know TikTok. Don't you think?
Don't hang me, we don't think it's a rope. Don't hang me. Hey, is it a little too early for being that loud? Hey, too late.
Can you do this job?
What's the O stand for?
You know what this is?
Oh, my God, it's early. Speaking of early, how about that Cro-Magnon Marty Drywitz? Thank you, Marty, for silky smooth sound. Make me sound like Peggy Lee.
This is Good Morning Vietnam. Hold on, let me see if I can find them soon.
Artillery! Thank you, Bob. Can we play anything for you? Anything! Just play it loud, okay?
who gave any...
So anyway, he got a job as a radio host on Good Morning Vietnam. Could you get that gig?
I wish I could.
But that wasn't on the list?
Wasn't on the list.
Damn.
There was a job in Tampa for military police, but then I was like, man, I don't want to... It's not a far drive, but on Sunday, it took us literally almost 4 hours to get to Tampa. The traffic was horrendous.
Yeah.
There was so many accidents. And this is Tampa, which is an hour and a half drive normal. Yeah. Then there was another job in Miami, and then I'm like, damn, that's a six-year, you know, commitment. I don't want to drive five and a half hours down to Miami and back. So it was slim pickings, and then there's a thing what they call The Rock, where they can check like future like jobs and stuff, and there was literally nothing available in like the Central Florida area. Because, I mean, the whole point of me doing this is to stay in Orlando.
So, all right, let's go through this then. May 18th for 9 weeks, that's about 2 months. So May, June, July. So mid to late July, you're done with that first thing, boot camp. And that's going to be rough, I think, right?
Yeah.
And then what do you do after that?
And then after that, I go...
Hold on, time out. Where is boot camp?
In Fort Jackson, South Carolina.
South Carolina. And do you ever get to see Eunice during this time at all?
No.
So the whole 9 weeks, no?
Yeah, nothing.
Yeah, can you call?
Now, the thing is, there's some people say that they do allow, to, like, they give you your phone, like, on a Sunday for, like, 10 minutes or some other, like, everyone says it's all up to your, like, drill, like, your drill instructors. It's all up to them whether they want to give you time to be on your phone or not, but normally they don't.
Damn. I mean, I would definitely pull the I'm an old dude radio card thing because, you know, seriously, I would tell them you need to check in on the station or something. Hey, look, we're going to have dead air unless I call, but then just call Eunice instead. Seriously, I would definitely pull whatever card you can to get a little special treatment. You're 32 years old. Yeah. Like this little 18-year-old punk, you know? Ridiculous. But, I should get more privileges. I'm an old dude here.
For being 32, I mean, I will say I probably am like more fit than most there.
Yeah, and if not fit, certainly braggadocious, if not. Jesus. I'm just,
no, right, I mean, it is kind of like tough because then like, you kind of do like around the room and like, yeah, I'm 17. Yeah, I'm 21. I'm 22. I'm 32.
Like,
what? Yeah, I've lived.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
The drill sergeant goes around the room and is like, do you miss your mom? Do you miss your mom? Do you miss your mom? And he's like, I have a wife, drill sergeant. How are you handling being away from mom and dad? He's like, well, you know, I'm used to that. Wow. But my wife misses me. My wife? You're the first dude in the history of the reserves to roll in with a wife.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, I mean, it's crazy, too, because you do see, like, you scope everyone out, and I'm like, these are babies.
Yeah.
Like, these are babies. Like, this kid's, like, 5'2", weighs 100 pounds. Like,
let me ask if I need to understand this a little bit more. Number one, you're here for another 2 months.
Yes, sir.
No problem.
Yes, sir.
Then you're going to be gone for 9 weeks at basic training.
Yes, sir.
And then after that, what happens?
It's 9 weeks of it.
Nine more weeks. Yeah, now we're May, now this June, is my July, August, September.
October.
You'll be back in October.
Yeah.
And October, is there a break between
October,
these two
early
things?
November.
Is there a break between
now,
the two?
Like from reading, they said normally there is, but because of like COVID, no, there isn't. They say usually, normally, once like you graduate, you're off the next week.
So you're going straight from, sorry, that's the Army music.
Star Wars music.
No, it says it's the Army theme.
Oh, yeah, and surprisingly, no one was joining the Space Force.
Yeah.
There was no one there.
I mean, that's what I would want to do. Anyway, so then you go straight from Fort Jackson, South Carolina.
So Fort,
you know,
Leonard,
I think
Wood.
I think I almost went in there one time. Is it right off the interstate? Because I took a wrong exit and they wouldn't let me through. I'm pretty sure that was it.
And it said no trespassing,
yeah,
U.S.
Yeah, yeah. I was like, I'm just trying to make a U-turn, sir. And all right, so then you're going to then get on a bus or something, you think, and go to where? Missouri?
To Missouri.
Ugh. No, there's nothing to do with Missouri. And then what kind of training is that? They're not slapping you around.
Well, I mean, there's still going to be physical fitness, but now this is my training for the actual job that I'm going to be doing.
But so this isn't the like the SEALs where you got to go underwater for an hour at a time right?
At least that I know of, no.
Good.
Maybe go in a gas chamber for an hour.
So at least when you come back, I mean, when you get back, you'll be able to test my Gatorade bottles for chemicals.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Okay. If you have the fruit punch one, but it's actually black, then I'll know that it's not. You know what I mean?
And then so 9 weeks of that, and then you return, you believe, to Orlando. Is that a sure thing?
That is a sure thing.
All right. So you will be back. probably October or so.
Yeah,
and once you
October,
come back,
latest early November.
And then once you come back, you just like, it's like regular life again. And then like every fourth weekend, you go hang out with the boys. I mean, I'm serious. I don't know how this works.
So then once I come back, is 1 week in a month of like drill training.
Yeah.
Yep. But the good thing is it's literally here. Like my unit's in Orlando, which is great.
Okay.
And it's so, from where I live right now, it's like 7 minutes away.
Oh.
So I won't have to stay at a hotel.
But that's only 1 weekend a month that you have to do that.
1 weekend
and,
a month.
And that's all you have to do.
Yep. And then
and you get free health insurance.
And then 2 weeks of during the summer of like training.
Yeah. And that's
then,
it?
Yeah. And then I'm here for the next 6 years.
Huh.
Wow. So, I mean.
And then, so let me, I don't know how to ask this the proper way. Because, you know, you never want to ask someone how much they make. Is it like a full-time low-paid job?
Oh, no, that you get paid just by like what you like. It's a part-time, so I'm only going to get paid for that Saturday and Sunday.
Oh, that's it?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean,
what about but are you paid for the entire the time that you're in training?
Oh, yeah, no, yeah, yeah. When I'm in basic training and AIT, I'm going to get paid more like full-time.
They give you what, 8 hours a day or how?
Oh, no, this is like a all, you know, you wake up, was it five o'clock in the morning and lights out at 9 p.m. Like every
but
single
just, so
day.
Do they pay you hourly or it's a salary?
It's a salary.
While you're
but
away.
But instead of going as an E1, I'll be going in as an E4.
Uh-huh.
So I'll be a specialist.
That because you're old, right? Okay. Is that why? I mean,
no,
seriously.
Because I have a degree.
Oh, so. I see. Interesting. I don't know how I feel about this. I mean, I guess they have to make you go through all this nonsense.
Well,
not
yeah,
nonsense,
I mean,
this hard stuff, because if not, everyone would want to be a reserve. I just got to go hang out on the weekends.
I mean, at the end of the day, just because I'm reserved doesn't mean I can't get deployed.
Right.
So now the chance of it happening is less, is low, mm-hmm. but there is that
possibility
that chance. Yeah.
Yeah.
They can say, well, you're going to Italy or Germany for the next 2 months.
What does Beanbag Nation think about this? Shocking news today. Shocking news. Lurch will be joining the United States Army Reserves. But he's going to be doing it in Orlando after he's gone for, what, 6 months or so?
Yeah.
He's going to be gone for 6 months getting pushed around, but then he's going to come back. He's going to come back here. And I believe he is going to drop names and things when he gets to boot camp. No, I think you are. Like, yo, come on, Sarge. I'm 32 years old.
No.
I'm 32. I'm a radio guy. Listen to my
voice.
Man, I mean, what do you think I do?
I don't give a damn.
No, I don't think so. I think they're going to give you special treatment. But I'd like to hear from Beanbag Nation as well. 321-339-1055. Let's start with Daryl, the pest guy. Good morning, show. Lurch, this is a big step. I'm proud of you, and I will miss you on the show while you were away.
I mean, I'm not going to lie. It's scary and exciting at the same time because this is a life-changing thing.
But,
and okay. I know I'm only reserved, but, I mean, this is a life-changing event for anyone.
Is it a money thing for you, or is it you really have always had a calling to
be
honest?
Well, back in 2006 when I was still in high school, I was going to join the Marines, but I needed parental consent. Like, I had a job. I had everything already lined up. But my mom said no.
Why?
So then because she didn't want me joining the military, and I was still 17, so I couldn't.
So you had no choice.
Join. So then I went to college, and then I was like, okay, well, I'm in college now. I'm not going to just leave now. And then actually when I was about to finish at UCF, I told myself, well, if I don't get a freaking hotel job, because I had applied even to be like housekeeper or whatever, and like no one was calling me back, I said, you know what? I'll join. But then I got hired at the Hyatt. And then, you know, years go by, and now I'm just at that point where it's like, if I don't do this now, I'm never going to do it.
Mm-hmm.
And we only have one life to live.
Who do you think is going to be stronger, you after 9 weeks of boot camp or me after 9 weeks of 20 minutes a week at the body street? What do you think?
You want to put it to the test?
Yeah, I do. I mean, I know where my body mass index is now, and I'm going to get tested every 2 weeks. But I'm putting in a solid 20 minutes a week at body street on these biceps, you know? We'll do a little muscle off when you return.
All right.
We'll see.
Or you know, what we can do is
what?
We'll do like when I return, we'll do like a day in the life of what we did in boot camp. We'll have you do, see if you can do it.
Yeah. I don't think okay. We'll see.
But it's going to be everything to the T. You're like wake up, time you eat, time you run, and do whatever.
It's going to be tough.
I mean, do everything.
I would like to try that. I would like to try some of the stuff, but I'm not starting the stuff that you were doing after 8 weeks. Yeah. I'm going to start the stuff you were doing day one or two. Yeah, that only makes sense.
Yeah, yeah,
of course, of course. Yeah, yeah, I'm not going to have you run 10 miles in 5 minutes.
Colin checks in. Outstanding, Lurch. I would have loved to serve with you. Aww. Hope you picked a cushy aviation MOS.
Sadly, no.
No, no. He's doing chemicals because he's watched enough snaps. He wants to put this thing to use back in the home country. Now they can use their cell phones at night and basic. It snowflakes out. Oh, really? So he might be able to use his phone at night anyway. You can FaceTime the house. You have a degree. You should have went as an officer.
No, yeah, I've thought about that. Oh. It was a super long process, but once I'm in, they said after 6 months I can...
Become an officer.
A petition to be an officer, yes.
Well, that's messed up. Why can't you just go right in with it? I don't understand. Well, I don't know how this all works. I'm learning with you today.
No, I mean, I asked the recruiter, but they said it's a longer process from if you're a civilian as opposed to when you're already in it.
Wow.
So I just said, well, then you know what? I'll just wait till I'm in. Because, I mean, at the end of the day, I might just be fine with just where I'm at and leave it as is. And maybe not want to be an officer.
Yeah. Hey,
but if the opportunity is there, then why not?
Cindy checks in. Oh, Lurch, I'm so proud of you. The audience will truly miss you while you're gone and your good insights, including me. But can't wait to have you back. And from all accounts, he's coming back. So,
yes, right? I know of, yes.
And so from all accounts, he's coming back. I mean, he might be back sooner than we think. If he can't do those pull-ups, Kayla, they're going to send him packing, right?
That's true.
It's kind of like law school. They try to run some of us off after year one. I don't know how it works in reserve school. Do they try to run people off? I think they do.
I don't know.
I do. Franklin, what's up, brother? How are you? Franklin, are you there, buddy?
What?
I
know you're there.
Oh, hey, buddy. I thought you didn't hear us pick up. I wanted to hear your conversation. I would never do that to you. I would never blast your private conversation on the radio. What's up, Franklin?
Oh, no, I'm just enjoying my day off. I'm about to take my kid to the park here in a little bit, but I just wanted to call and congratulate Lurch on
appreciate that.
Going to the Army Reserve. I actually tried to go into the military right out when I was about 20 years old, but because I was homeschooled, the military made it extra difficult for me to even get into the military.
Really?
What was? Yes. They're not like that anymore. But when about 10, 12 years ago, when I tried to go into the military to pass the ASVAB to go where I was wanted to go into, basically I only had to get a 40 or a 35. But because I was homeschooled, they upped it to where I had to get a 60 or 65 to pass. And I got a 59 on the ASVAB, and they still wouldn't let me go.
That's messed up. If I were homeschool, try to cancel something, right? I would. I think that you guys should all rise up together and really pitch a fit. I mean, look, if we can't have Mr. Potato Head, we can't be requiring homeschool kids to get a better grade or whatever.
Yeah, but they were like that for a long time. Then about 4 years later, things changed, but by the time things had changed, I had became a type 1 diabetic, so I couldn't join anyway.
Yeah, exactly. All right, brother, enjoy your day off. Take that beautiful daughter to the park, brother.
Oh, I will.
All right, pal. Thanks a lot.
All right.
Bye-bye. Bye. You know, I also heard that they're thinking about making the United States Postal Service the fifth branch of the military as well. I did. Al, is that right? Is Saran Wrap Al is here. Is that right? Are they thinking about making the Postal Service the fifth branch?
The which branch?
The fifth. I heard the Postal Service was going to be the fifth branch of the United States military because of all the stuff you guys see down in the trenches.
Yeah, we're tough. We're tough out here.
What's going on?
Nothing, man. I don't know. Congratulations, Lurch. I'm glad you're doing what you want to do.
Thank you.
But Jesus, Justin, what are you doing to scare
people away? Look, it's a valid question.
We knew that was going to happen.
It's a very valid question. And it's weird, too, because at the law firm, most of my employees have been there for years, but at the radio station, I don't know if they get an ass wipe version of me or what, but I'm normally a relatively nice guy.
I have a feeling that they're afraid of Shannon.
Yeah, let's deflect it on Shannon.
I mean,
I think that's
week
I like
it's
this.
The battery, you know, 1 week it's the battery in the mouse. The 1 week it's the spinner that you talk to. You know. I think he's ruffling the place up, man.
Yeah, I mean, you know, he does have quite a presence when he walks in. So we'll see.
Yeah.
But, you know, the good thing is I believe this is a temporary assignment.
Yes.
So he'll be back and better than ever.
He's going to come back, right?
Yeah, he's coming back.
As long as Justin will have me back, yes.
Do you need me to fill in?
Yeah, we'll definitely get you down here a few times. And
I'm not trying to benefit from him leaving. You know, I just, you know.
Of course. Yeah, trust me. There's already a long line of Twitter messages right now I'm getting saying, oh, we wish him well, but someone needs to be in that seat.
Oh, my God. Could you imagine you and Ed Till together on the same show? Yeah. I love it.
I know.
Love you guys.
I love you too, man. Bye-bye.
Bye.
It's fine. Yeah, I mean, what a position to be in as a boss. It's, hey, I'm going to join the military to help support your country, but I get to come back. Will you have me back? It's hard to say no to that, isn't it? You know what I mean? Like, you're out there trying to fight for our country, but I'm not going to take you back when you get back. It's crazy. Who's this?
Let me tell you something, brother. I'm in the ring right now. I'm getting clanging and banging in the gym, getting ready to listen to Justin Clark's show. Going to drop them 24-inch cheesesteaks on you. You know what I'm talking about, Justin.
I got you now. Hey, maybe we should have a L'Espada's going away party for this man, too. I mean, he is going to fight for our country, you know.
Well, true. On a part-time basis.
On a part-time basis. So can you give him half of a L'Espada sub?
Give me the kids one that I got last time.
Listen, I'll give you the full size with the Mr. Potato Head, and I'll put on a male outfit, and we'll go deliver mail before you go away.
All right.
By the way,
we'll be in the fifth branch.
But this is Vincent L'Espada, by the way. By the way, I listened to the Vincent L'Espada show this Saturday on my way home from the office. It was very good, excellent pipes, and great interview with, I don't know her name, was a female wrestler. That was a good interview.
Ray Lynn.
There you go. And I did look her up on my phone while driving home to you know, just to see what she was all about.
See what she looked like.
She's tough, man.
Yeah.
She's tough.
I wouldn't mess with her.
Yeah.
I wouldn't mess her with Lurch's biceps. Oh. You know what I'm saying? All right, Vinny.
Well, Lurch, listen, man. Lurch, I'm glad to see you doing what you want to do, man, and we're going to miss you here, and hopefully we'll hear you back here in Orlando sometime soon.
Yes, very soon. October, November.
All right, Vinny. Later, bro.
All right.
All right, let's do this, because I have a ton more questions to ask and 1,000 text messages
and
to get to as well.
Some answers.
If you want to give Lurch your thoughts, advice, congratulations, whatever it is, call or text 321-339-1055. We will continue on this subject after this very short break. It's the Lurch Show on the Florida Man Radio Network.
You're listening to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark. Florida Man Radio.
Previously on the Bubba the Love Sponge Show.
How long would you stay alive based on your BMI, and how long would I stay alive?
Well, I'd probably stay alive longer because ultimately I'd kill you and eat you.
Okay, Dan, we're not making it straight.
If we're going
of course,
straight.
We always got to make it a competition, and Dan's always got to win. But what Dan doesn't realize is I always win because I'll just turn his mic off.
In the wild, you're going to turn his mic off?
Yeah, in the wild. Yeah, exactly.
Bubba the Love Sponge, morning 6 till 10 on Florida Man Radio.
Are you a business owner? Well, first of all, thanks for listening. If you want to find new customers, we can help on Orlando's newest radio station, WDYZ Florida Man Radio, 105.5 FM, 660 AM. Your ad could be featured right here in the morning with Bubba the Love Sponge. Key placement 10 till noon in You Have Power Radio with Justin Clark. Noon till 3 with the Ed Till Show. Or in Prime PM Drive during the Shannon Burke Show. We can create a custom campaign based on your goals and budget. Drive store traffic, engage new clients, develop more leads, boost website activation, and get your cash registered to ring with new business. Radio gets results, and JVC Broadcasting is ready to help take your business to the next level. For more information on increasing your success, visit our website at floridamanradio.com and click on the Advertise tab. Drive store traffic, engage new clients, develop more leads, boost website activation, and get your cash register to ring with new business. Let us help you grow your business.
Reach out today, unfiltered, unafraid. floridamanradio.com. Click on the Advertise tab,
Do it now.
The weather is warming up and spring break is around the corner. Where are you off to? With Giant Recreation World, you can travel anywhere, anytime. Buy, sell, consign, trade up, or rent. New inventory is arriving all the time. And all new and selected pre-owned RVs come with a lifetime warranty. Pay zero down and no payments for 60 days for those who qualify. Plan your spring adventure now with Giant Recreation World. Visit a location near you in Winter Garden, Destination Daytona, and Palm Bay. Or online anytime at GiantRecreationWorld.com.
Don't make it weird, but we need to talk about dumps for a second.
Ew.
I'm talking big, heavy-duty dump trailers. Dump trailers are hard to find right now, but not at Main Street Mower. In fact, we have all types of trailers. If you're a landscaper or in construction, if you do pavers or just need a way to move your toys, you need to come by Main Street Mower and see our selection of amazing American-made trailers like Big Tech's and more. We're family-owned and operated with two locations, Claremont and Winter Garden. Main Street Mower, the place for trailers.
Spring can sometimes mean hailstorms. Did you know most roof damage due to non-hurricane events like hail come without hefty out-of-pocket deductibles?
Visit KarmaRoofing.com or call me Anoop Naive at Karma Roofing and Restoration. It'll ring right to my cell phone.
Karma can handle repairs and re-roofs as well as replacing, installing garage doors, windows, gutters, or screen enclosures, and anything on the inside of your home, too. Kitchen and bathroom models, flooring, and total rehabs. Call 407-860-3498. KarmaRoofing.com. CC number 132-8218.
Adam and Eve is not giving you 10% off and not 20% off or even 40%. Your discount is even bigger. AdamandEve.com is giving you a whopping 50% off. But why stop there? In addition to 50% off, you also get 10 free gifts. That includes a racy item for him, a sensuous toy for her, and something we know you'll both enjoy.
Ooh.
And 6 extra special bonus items that are sure to rev your engine, pique your curiosity,
ooh,
and even blow you away. And best of all, free shipping. Always delivered in discreet packaging. So rethink your bedroom routine. Go to AdamandEve.com and enter the station's exclusive code at checkout, FLMAN, and get, you know the discount, 50% off almost any item and 10 tantalizing free gifts. That's FLMAN, FLMAN.
If you're a Central Florida business in recovery mode, then your strategic marketing is more important than ever. That includes signs, banners, menus, promotional items, customized shirts, printing, embroidery, or whatever.
Hi, this is Anthony with Elite Signs and Graphics. Please call us so we can provide a free quote and a consultation for you today.
Elite Signs and Graphics would love the opportunity to earn your business. Many items available for same-day turnaround and curbside pickup. Call Elite Signs and Graphics at 407-898-0111. Stop in at 240 North Orlando Avenue in Winter Park. Or check them out online at EliteSignsAndGraphics.com. EliteSignsAndGraphics.com.
Get your fix of Florida Man Radio anytime and anywhere you are. Of course, you can catch Florida Man on 660 AM and 105.5 FM. But now you can listen wherever you are with the all-new Florida Man Radio app. And don't miss a second of the conversation at home by listening on your Alexa device. Just say, Alexa, play 105.5 Florida Man Radio. Florida Man is everywhere, unfiltered, unafraid. Get it how you need to, now. Now, back to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark.
Lurch leaving us for a few months, but don't worry, he's going to be here through mid-May. But he's leaving us to become a member of the United States military, the Army Reserves to be exact. Are you, be honest, are you doing it for country or for the free health insurance or the $40 health insurance?
I don't, okay. I don't get free health insurance.
Oh, but it's only $40, you said.
Yeah, which is good.
Now, the one thing we have not addressed as of yet is your beautiful almost bride. We got engaged at an apple orchard in North Carolina just a few mere months ago. Is there a wedding date?
We don't want to talk about this. No, we're going to elope, actually.
Oh, prior to your departure. Mm-hmm. It's not a deployment, it's a departure.
Yeah, my departure, yes.
Okay. For South Carolina.
Yes.
And now the fort, what is it in South Carolina?
That's Fort Jackson.
Fort Jackson. Is it notoriously rough, or is it sort of a cakewalk?
I don't know. Some people call it relaxing Jackson. Huh. Some other people say, no, that there is no relaxing.
Hmm. Are you going to take your favorite My Pillow with you?
I don't think they'll allow me here.
You're not going to take your favorite blankie with you?
No.
You're going to use the government-issued blankie?
Yes.
Okay.
But the thing is, I mean, Eunice, of course, like, she's, like, happy, but at the same time, she's, like, sad, nervous, pissed, angry. Yeah, angry.
Is she mad? Has she been a little bit rough with you?
No, but she's just, like, she understands, but she's like, you're going to be away for, like, so long, for, like, 6 months, and what am I going to do? And I'm like, well, I mean, I'm going to be helping you, like, financially, like, I can do that, but, like, we do have 2 months, at least, to, like, try to prepare for my...
for her emotion.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's tough. That's going to be a tough one, for sure. But anyway, Colin texted in and said it's a little bit more of a cakewalk now, and they will let you use your phone at night.
Oh, great.
So that would be good. So now you guys can at least FaceTime or whatever. Yeah. Let's hear from you. Any thoughts on Lurch joining the Army Reserves, 321-339-1055. Let's see. Karen is here. Good morning, Karen. Good morning, friends. Congratulations, Lurch. I will miss you. But I'm so happy you'll be back. Beanbag Nation will keep Justin in line. I have no doubt. Beanbag Nation always keeps me
in line.
When I come
back, it's going to be a...
yes, we're going to have a going away party for Lurch. Absolutely. We are having a going away party for you. You know, I think what we should do, Casey's in Lake Mary. Let's go see my boy Mark again. Let's run that back where we had the party before... Yeah. What event was that? We had a pre-party there.
That was just like a gathering.
But prior to what?
I think it was the one-year anniversary.
Yeah. And that was at Casey's in Lake Mary.
That is correct.
All right, so let's go ahead and start planning that around May. The weird thing is we're planning a party at a bar for a dude who doesn't drink. That's the only issue. I mean, would you rather...
You often drink. Yeah.
Would you rather go jump roping or something? I don't know.
Let's go to the trampoline world.
You want to go to trampoline world instead? We will definitely have... Absolutely, we'll be having a going-away party. More information to come. Yeah. Certainly, it'll be at Casey's in Lake Mary. My boy Mark, I know, will take care of you.
And the tough part... I don't say tough part, but back when Brianna was leaving, we all, like, she had came to me and she told me, like, what was happening.
Before I found out. Yes, I remember. Just,
in my head, I was like, oh, my Lord.
What?
Like, she's leaving, and then I'm like, now I have to tell this man.
I'm quitting too?
Not quitting, but for a short time. But, I mean, it will, like, impact your show in the sense that when I come back, I know you're going to have a different flow, a different stream. So I would hope that I would have a place back, but I also would understand that, like, if you didn't want to mess things up, because, I mean, let's face it, six months is a long time.
Yeah, but it's one thing if you said, hey, I'm taking a sabbatical and I'm going to go camping through Italy because I'm hitting a midlife crisis. And then if you came back, it would be a different story. But saying you're going to join the military to protect my family and me, it's a little bit of a different situation.
True.
I'm going to go through Italy. I've been stressed out. I'm going to go through Italy and go to hostel to hostel. Yeah. Okay, a-hole. I'll see you again never. But, you know, saying you're going to go join the army is a little bit of a different departure. Wouldn't you say?
Yes.
Like with Brianna, she's going to go roofing company. Yeah. Okay, bye. You know what I mean? You're going to go camping through France. Okay, bye. But headed to Fort Jackson to get your ass kicked.
Oh.
A little bit different. To fight for my country.
But like I said, my vision is to do that, come back, proceed like normal, continue busting your chops 1 week in a month, and see where that goes.
Columbo wants to say hello. Congrats, Lurch. I went through MEPS. What is that?
MEPS.
MEPS. Yeah. Duh. Listen. I went through MEPS in Tampa. That's what
you... That's where I went. Yeah.
Oh. Okay. Basic and AIT. All these you guys. I don't know all these little initials and things.
I don't know them all yet, but I will know them.
Yeah. Basic and AIT at Fort Leonard. Fort Leonard Wood. That's where you're going?
Yeah, that's where I'm going.
Fort Leonard Wood, Missouri. As a 12B, how could you? You need to take a whole 9 weeks to learn all these. A 12B combat engineer.
Yep, that's a combat engineer. I'm a 74D, so 74 Delta.
Oh, so 74 is more than 12. Does that mean anything?
No.
Dude, run 2 miles a day, push ups, sit ups. Now you got to do deadlifts, get in good shape, man.
Yeah, I have to.
So when are you going to start that? I mean, I'm not saying you're like a Big Mac right now.
No. Even though yesterday I did have a chicken tender sub from Publix.
Oh, that's a good
start.
And then
Eunice was like, okay, so when are you going to start the
non-Taco Bell?
I said, soon.
Colombo said, did you take your AVAB test yet? Yes. AVAB test yet.
The ASVAB, yeah. I took that. So I took that, I think, last month.
This will determine your MOS. Please, I can't figure any of that. And I don't know whether I say MOS or MOS. And I'm going to sound like an idiot every time I read these messages. In fact, can you just call in when you have this many symbols or whatever it is?
Yeah.
Please. Because I'm looking like the idiot here.
No, I did.
Do you know what your MOS is?
Yeah. Which
what is
that? 74 Delta. That's like.
What does that mean?
It's your job.
Your job.
My job, yeah.
So why don't we just say J-O-B, job? I'm just thinking out loud.
It's your military occupation specialty.
Okay. U.S. Army, hoo-ah!
That's right.
Lurch, watch out for Jody, said Columbo.
Oh, Jody.
Babby checks in. Good morning, Babby. Good morning, Lurch. We will miss you. Good luck. I know Justin will miss you, too. Hurry back. Yes, I will. Oh, 909.
I mean, my plan is to come back and continue here.
Let's see.
That's
here.
The plan.
Yep.
909 checks in. Where's 909?
Let's see.
Where's 909? I want to figure out where 909 is. 909 is...
San Bernardino County.
Oh.
L.A.
What's up, 909? Welcome to the show. I do some research. You can be deployed at any time, and I've never heard of a two-month deployment unless it's a national emergency. Recruiters lie. Uh-oh. Might want to double-check that.
Right.
I mean, these recruiters are kind of like sales guys, I think. Yeah. They, like, try to sell you to come into the service,
they
I
do.
Believe. But Lurch seemed to have a pretty good relationship with his. Robert in Georgia. What up, Robert? It's a great service to our country. Thanks, brah. My son graduates early and heading to the Marines in May. RJ in Georgia. Well, thank you to your son for signing up. Fish is here. What's up, Fish? Morning, peeps. Congratulations, Lurch. You are an American hero. Your new name is G.I. Lurch.
G.I. Lurch.
Lurch us.
Specialist Reyes.
Lurch, off to the military. United States Army Reserves, starting May 18th. You do need to get in shape, pal. I'm not saying you're a wreck.
I have to get in shape. Because the last thing I need is to get over there and freaking die on the first day.
Oh, no.
Henry is here. Good morning, all. Wow, Lurch, congratulations, my man. A full salute to you, sir. Show them what the older guys have. Thank you for your service. Jeremy is here. Good morning, Beanbag Nation. Congratulations, Lurch. Good for you.
Appreciate it.
Rich is here. Congratulations, Lurch. Hopefully you have a more positive experience than the people I know in the service right now. All of them have seen drastic changes since Biden took over. Most, if not all, plan on leaving the service when their time is up. Uh-oh. Mm-mm. You knew that was bound to happen.
All we can do is hope.
Yeah. Yeah. Kevin is here. What's up, Kevin in Georgia? Well, what the hell is going on? First we lose one person. Now we're going to lose Lurch as well. Oh, my God. Kevin from Georgia. Good luck, Lurch. I was in the military as well. Dave the drummer. What's up, Dave? Good morning, gang. Lurch and I already decided the new name, Justin. Yeah, it's the Justin Clark Show. I know you guys did. Congratulations, Lurch, and thank you for serving. Lee checks in. Oops. Lee's drinking a beer already. See? That was Lee. Lee, it's too early, bud. It's 5 o'clock somewhere. Lee is here. Good morning there, Captain Colonel Clarkey. Hey, buddy. How are you? Brad checks in. Brad, what's up, my brother? How are you?
Hey, this isn't actually Brad.
Oh.
Sorry, you sounded like Brad from Georgia.
Right,
well, yeah, he doesn't need hearing in the military, thank God.
it's actually Kevin from Georgia.
Kevin. Kevin from Cobb County.
There we go.
What's up, Kev?
I did send in a text message, and I do want to congratulate Lurch, but what is going on with the show?
Well, apparently, I'm running people off left and right.
You made me go to the military.
Yeah. What it is, I'm so narcissistic that I want the show to be all about me. And so deep down, I'm trying to push people away. You see, I want to get, I keep making the mistake of talking to my producers and guest host, and I get to the point where I'm like, I don't want to hear their voices, and neither does my audience. I want it to be all about me, and I try to push them out subconsciously.
Oh wow!
No, I'm just kidding. Wow. That's not it at all. That's not it.
Anyway, I was going to tell Lurch that my son is actually stationed at Camp Lejeune, which is right next to. Yeah, he's in the Marine Corps. And I actually was in the Marine Corps for 8 years.
Wow.
It is a lifestyle. I actually joined. My parents did sign for me when I was 17. I got out of military school early, and I wanted to join the Marine Corps. I went in. I served my first 4 years, and then I re-upped for another 4 years. And I got out. I loved every minute of it. My first wife didn't, you know, yeah. So we ended up going through that. But whatever. And at any rate, it is a lifestyle, and it is awesome. I actually taught the reservist over at Dobbins Air Force Base, which is right there wow. in Marietta for a year and a half, which was the best job I ever had. And I think you're going to have a great time in there. Even being a reservist, they always seem to have a great time while I was out there. I witnessed it. They always seem to have a good time. I don't know about the not drinking part. That's going to be tough on
you. I'll hold my hold my ground.
They do like to have fun there. Uh-huh. And the Marines were always a pretty good bunch because we had the Toys for Tots, which was also with the Hooters girls. So yeah.
Oh, he likes Hooters girls. He just doesn't drink beer.
Yeah.
That's it. He'll go to Hooters. All right.
Hey, hook up with some of them Marines.
Yeah, exactly.
So I was telling Lurch that if he wanted to, my son could show him a pretty good time over that way. I mean, I know he doesn't drink, but he can show him the town.
Yeah.
My son's been up there for 4 years. He's fixing to get out, but there you go.
Well, we really appreciate it. Thanks for your service.
You did 8 years, man.
I hope you're able to keep the show going just as good as it is, and I know you will.
Yeah.
Justin, I know you work hard. So, and I hope Lurch gets back soon.
Thanks for your service, Kevin. Hey, we love you, brother. Talk to you soon.
I love you guys, I love you guys.
Except it's pretty messed up. Kevin's looking for a designated driver for his son right here on my radio show. That's so messed up. You know, I mean, hey, Kevin, there's Uber, Lyft. You don't need to try to connect these two so your son gets a DD on my dime. Unbelievable. I'm just kidding. See, Sean is here. What up, Sean? Congratulations, Lurch. Be all you can be. Better learn how to drink now. Well, seems to be a theme here, Lurch. Maybe you should pull the, because of my radio career, I have to protect my voice and I'm not allowed to drink. It being total BS, of course, but that, you could use that as an excuse, don't you think?
Yeah.
Hey, what do you think is more respectable? Not being a member of the National Guard or Army Reserves?
I think they both can be respectable.
Which one? Yeah. Okay. Well, don't BS me. Which one's more legit?
Well, not the more legit. I would say that you'd get more. Well, it depends because I mean the National Guard can be like on. Because
I get them confused, honestly. Because the National Guard, they go once a week, once a month for a weekend, and 2 weeks a year too, right? Is it the same concept?
I'm not sure, but I know the National Guard. I know they're governed by like the state governor.
Yeah.
But of course, the federal government can supersede the governor and call on the National Guard. But I know the governor can't call on the Army like reserve.
Did the station put you up to this, considering we're going into a market in a couple of weeks heavy military?
No.
They're trying to do this for ratings. No.
I've honestly thought about it for a good while. Mm-hmm. And
so this wasn't Shane Reeves saying, bro.
No.
We'll double your pay here. You go, you know, give me 9 weeks up at Fort Jackson. And that way we can talk to our new audience in the Fort Walton-Destin area about how we really support the military. No? It's not a station ploy?
No, it's not a station ploy.
So this is really a Lurch thing.
Yeah, this is a me thing.
Okay,
I said, I'm not getting any younger.
Yeah,
I'm never going to do it. And I don't want to, let's say, later on down the road in my life, look back and say, you know what, I wish I could have joined or I wish I should have, but I didn't.
Rick checks in Maldora. What up, Rick? Much respect, Lurch. I enjoyed my time in the service and hope you have a good experience as well. How's the food? Any porterhouse on the weekends or anything?
No,
or no?
I don't think so.
No? That sucks. Seriously. What are they feeding you up there? I mean, that would be the first thing I would ask. Like, which fort has the better food? That's all I care about. Mike is here. What's up, Mike? How are you, brother? Desert Storm Mike here. Lurch, please get in really good shape. If they see you are weak, they will be all over you and break you down. Get strong, brother.
Yes, sir.
And send in his love. Dennis and who knows where is here. Congratulations, Lurch. Props for your commitment. You are joining an elite group of patriots. Stand proud. Yeah. I agree with that. Daryl the Pest Guy checks in. Good morning, Daryl. How are you? Good morning, guys. Lurch is a big step. I'm proud of you. I will miss you on the show for a little bit, but we'll see you soon. Who is going to tell Ed Till when he needs to take a break? Well, let's be honest. No. Ed wasn't listening anyway. So, right? I mean, when you tell Ed to take a break, it's just it's mere advisement. Yeah. There's not any requirement. Isn't that true?
It's just I'm just required to tell him that. Exactly. That's it. I'm just doing my job. I just saying it, and that's it.
Yeah. Karen is here. Justin's brain is about to explode with all these acronyms. That's true, but thank you, because I couldn't find the word acronym in my brain. And thank you, because it was driving me crazy. Colin checks in. Good morning, Colin. They don't try to weed anybody out. I got kids from AIT that failed their PT test. Here we go with these acronyms.
Physical fitness.
AIT, you will be asked by everyone to buy alcohol for them. Don't do it.
I want to put myself in a compromising situation.
Yeah, exactly. Al the mailman checks in. What's up, Al? Hey, now that I think about it, I think he is trying not to get married right away. What do you think, Justin? I don't know. Is there any truth to that?
No.
Is this a dilatory tactic? No.
No.
So you're going to elope before you go?
Yes.
Before you go.
Mm-hmm.
And are you going to like go out of town, or what do you think you're going to do?
Well, I mean, it's as simple as going online.
You want me to call Grant Malloy? Yeah. Grant will come here and do it for you. Seminole County Clerk.
Filling out the paperwork and then making the appointment at the Orange County Clerk of Courts.
Just wear your mask.
Yeah.
At the courthouse.
We're going to be doing that. It's tough because I know I have time, but at the same time, it's like it's going to go by so fast, and I need to like sit down and like with Eunice and be like, okay, this is what we need to do in order to prepare for this.
Fish checks in with a great idea. Lurch, you've got to have one drink with Beanbag Nation one time at Casey's in Lake Mary before being shipped off like an Amazon package. Could you agree
to
one?
I'm sorry, but I can't.
Not even one?
Not even one.
What about some Listerine? There's alcohol
in
there.
I'm not
going to
drink Listerine.
What if you spit the vodka out? You spit it out. Will you do that at least?
No.
We want a little alcohol on your lips, buddy.
Why don't you drink?
Because I just don't. It doesn't attract me. It doesn't do anything for me.
Okay, got it.
Like I don't go to a place and I'm like, you know what? I could use a Coors Light or a White Claw, or I could use a.
And, you know, growing up in the rave scene like he did, you know, when they were on Molly, they really enjoyed water with the Molly. They really didn't like to wash their Molly down with booze. Oh, it was more like a cold bottle of water when he did all the Molly back in the day. It's true. You know how that goes, right? I mean, the Molly kids, they just don't like booze. They
Molly
like to.
Kids.
He would do Molly and Red Bull like it was going out of style.
The Four Loko era. That was my era.
Oh, all right, let's take a break. When we get back, more about how Lurch is going to adjust to this new lifestyle, a military lifestyle. Is he going to come back? When is he going to come back? And also, the CDC, yes, the Centers for Disease Control, as you know. Yeah, that's the only acronym I know. As you know, issued a moratorium on evictions. Which is weird for the Center for Disease Control to deal with real estate. I agree with you. But they gave an eviction on, or excuse me, a moratorium on evictions, I think, last September. And now it expires at the end of March. However, despite this moratorium, the White House had some evictions over the weekend. The Joe Biden White House evicted something over the weekend.
March 9th?
I'll tell you about that and plenty more. Quick break in the news. It's Justin Clark on the Florida Man Radio Network.
You're listening to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark. Florida Man Radio. The Shannon Burke Show.
Hey, Jeff, come back here. You want to pee? We all pee in the same place, back here in the back.
You can imagine how great he would be
come
with
on
that.
Back here. I know you... Eating so much pork makes you want to pee so bad, Jeff. Come back here. I'll tell you where we pee, the Cuban people.
Some more cerveza.
Yes. What's that milky white stuff we drink? I forget what that's called. What is it? Comes in a jar, you know?
The Shannon Burke Show. Afternoons from 3 to 7 on Florida Man Radio.
Sick and tired of hearing contractors try to sell you something you don't need? The folks at Impact Electric of Orlando are tired of it too. Impact Electric is committed to getting the job done right the first time. They listen to you, not to the contractor's agenda. With over 10 years experience, Impact Electric of Orlando focuses on residential and commercial electrical needs. Get it done right with Impact Electric of Orlando. Call 407-747-0874. That's 407-747-0874.
Hi, this is Connie Gellner from your local Stanley Steamer. It's time to get back to clean for spring. Area rugs, carpet, tile and grout, hardwood floors, upholstery, air ducts, we clean it all. Give us a call today at 1-888-STEEMER.
Spring can sometimes mean hailstorms. Did you know most roof damage due to non-hurricane events like hail come without hefty out-of-pocket deductibles?
Visit KarmaRoofing.com or call me Anoop Naeed at Karma Roofing and Restoration. It'll ring right to my cell phone.
Karma can handle repairs and re-roofs as well as replacing, installing garage doors, windows, gutters, or screen enclosures, and anything on the inside of your home, too. Kitchen and bath remodels, flooring, and total rehabs. Call 407-860-3488. KarmaRoofing.com. CC number 132-821.
Frogger's Grill and Bar locations are open for business. Oviedo, Apopka, Altamont Springs, Mount Dora, and Old Town, Monday through Sunday, in compliance with all state guidelines. Frogger's has plenty of to-go boxes, so you can still take advantage of their takeout service or through their delivery service partners. If you are ready to get out, Frogger's is the place. Frogger's Grill and Bar locations are open for business. Oviedo, Apopka, Altamont Springs, Mount Dora, and Old Town, Monday through Sunday. And don't miss out on Frogger's amazing menu, where everything is fresh, never frozen. Frogger's Grill and Bar, hopping with food and fun.
So you've got a clunker in the driveway, and you don't know what to do with it? Budget You Pull It. They buy junkers. That's right. Budget You Pull It pays top dollar for junk autos. Call them and they'll give you an appraisal on the spot. Can't drive it in? They'll make arrangements to pick it up. Budget You Pull It. Low-cost auto parts and they'll buy your junker. Visit them today on 9th Street, just off Highway 50 in Winter Garden, or budgetyoupullit.com.
Hey guys, newsflash. Having a hairy nutsack is no longer in style. Hey, it's Shannon Burke, and Manscaped has hooked me and my boys up with their perfect package 3.0 kit. Right now, get 20% off and free shipping with the code FLMAN at manscaped.com. You heard me, 20% off and free shipping with the code FLMAN at manscaped.com. Guys, trim your junk safely, and for God's sakes, use a different trimmer for your face. I use it, I love it, and so will you and your woman. 20% off with the code FLMAN at manscaped.com. Your balls will thank you.
It's time to spring into action and dive into savings now at Creative Floors. Hi, Nancy here. With 1 year no interest financing, now is not the time to be missing out on the great savings on all flooring throughout our showrooms. Whether it's carpet, hardwood, vinyl plank, laminate, or tile, we have the products, the savings, and the knowledgeable team to help you find the perfect flooring for your home and your budget. Visit us at creativefloorsonline.com for locations where it's worth talking to the experts at Creative Floors.
I'm News 6 anchor Justin Mormuth. Here are your Tuesday headlines. Starting next week, all Floridians ages 60 and up will be eligible to get the coronavirus vaccine. The governor announced the change as demand for seniors to get the shot is declining. Meantime, leaders in Orange County say all first responders and those considered vulnerable to the virus can now get vaccinated at the convention center. Investigators now say a man shot and killed in Orlando had ties to recent gang violence. Police say Demetrius Cox bonded out of jail in Osceola County just hours before his death early yesterday. He was accused of killing a man at a house party last April. No arrests have been made in Cox's death. And the next rocket launch from the Space Coast could be just hours away. SpaceX is looking to send dozens more high-speed internet satellites into orbit. If everything goes according to plan, liftoff will be just before 10 p.m. Remember, you can get breaking news around the clock on clickorlando.com and the News 6 app. Have a great day.
WDYC, Altamont Springs. WYGC, High Springs.
A JVC broadcasting station.
660 AM, 105.5 FM.
Florida Man Radio.
Now, back to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark.
Hour number two begins. Lurch is leaving us to head to boot camp. Well, we still have 2 months with him, though.
Yeah.
And allegedly, he's coming back stronger than ever. Kayla's here to my right. Private Lurch directly in front of me. Beanbag Nation with you as always if you want to join us. It's 321-339-1055. Everything I learned about boot camp, I unfortunately learned from Full Metal Jacket.
From the movie.
The movie. Have you ever seen Full Metal Jacket? Don't watch it before you haven't seen it. Don't watch it. Don't watch it between now and May 18th. Or certainly, I don't know. Hey, can you unsign that form? Was it DocuSign or is it like a real signature? Because you could just pretend like that was somebody else. That wasn't my IP address.
Electronic.
This is all I know. Hold on. This is what you're headed for.
Did your parents have any children that lived?
Sir, yes, sir.
I bet they regret that. You're so ugly you could be a modern art masterpiece. What's your name, fat body?
Sir, Leonard Lawrence, sir.
Lawrence, what, of Arabia?
Sir, no, sir.
That...
Okay, I gotta stop it at that point.
Yeah.
It gets a little bit more vulgar. You know, it's rough. He says, do you... never mind. But Full Metal Jacket, what a movie. Yeah. But that's what I think of boot camp. And that's where you're headed?
Yeah, I'm headed to boot camp.
Something like that?
Yeah.
And you're going to be sleeping in the same room with like all these people and have a little chest thing at the end of the bed?
Yeah, but I think because of COVID, I think they said there's no one on the top bunk now.
So. No one? Oh, so great. So are they making the bottom bunk more comfortable all of a sudden?
I don't know, but... It seems like it's more like spaced out because of COVID now. Yeah.
I really think you would be a great radio guy. Don't they have radio guys? Do they have military radio stations anymore or no?
I mean, they have like the military like news and stuff like that. Yes, but I mean.
But what?
But getting that
job.
Great. Yeah, it'd be
amazing.
But
listen to you. Have you heard yourself?
Of course. Oh. But the people that are there, I mean, they're there. Like they're not going to just, you know what? This guy has a great voice. Let me step down and let him. Yeah. Of course, it's not going to happen.
Good morning, Vietnam! Hey, this is not a test. This is rock and roll.
You could do that, don't you think? So you can't find the good job, right? Because everyone wants those jobs.
Well, yeah.
That sucks. I mean, you'd be a great radio guy in the military.
Like, I had them look and check.
Yeah,
like,
radio stuff.
Because this is, well, I mean, just like in general, like jobs that I would, like I gave them, okay, this is what I like. Mm-hmm. And then they try to look for what you like. Of course, if you're qualified for that. And then we're like, well, this is what there is.
Yeah.
But it's either that or keep waiting and waiting and waiting and prolonging everything. And at the end of the day, it's still a 6-year commitment. So this isn't no, I'm going to go in and think I'm going to back out.
Mm-hmm. So I want to be clear about something. So your job, once you get out of the basic training and then that next thing you're talking about that has an acronym, I'm sure.
AIT.
AIT. You're going to be, what is the name of what your job is going to be? I want to make sure I'm clear on this.
Seaburn Specialist.
So and how do you spell Seaburn?
C-B-R-N.
Oh, see, I thought you were saying like S-E-A.
No.
Burn, like redneck, like a burn. No. Okay. Seaburn.
Chemical, biological, radiological, and nuclear specialist.
Another acronym. What is up with all these acronyms? If I didn't learn anything today, if I learned anything today, it's that... Holy hell, I need 9 months to learn all these acronyms. Seriously. I had no idea it was so acronym heavy in this military. Why do we do it like that? So the Chinese won't figure out what we're saying? I don't know. Why do we need so many acronyms?
It's just easier because imagine having to say chemical, biological, radical, and nuclear specialist every single.
So you're going to learn how
Seaburn.
To. Do you know exactly? What is the job description? You must have read the job description. What does it say about being a Seaburn?
I will protect the country against the threat of Seaburn weapons of mass destruction.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
I will employ the most advanced equipment and coordinate defense systems against these weapons of mass destruction in support of joint and combined armed operations.
Whoa. Now, did you just pull that up?
Yeah.
I didn't know if you had to, I didn't know they made you memorize it for day one or whatever.
I haven't memorized that yet.
Good. Wow. So, I mean, I think that's good.
I mean, the thing is, I mean, I did do a lot of, like, research on this, like, particular job.
Yeah, you did so much research, you took the only job available in Orlando.
Well,
no offense.
Well, yes. Okay. I mean, of course, but I'm not just going to, like, go in blind into this. And honestly, I mean, it was probably, like, 70-30 of people like, oh, no, this is a great job. This is a good job. And then, like, 30% are like, oh, this job sucks. I can't believe I'm in this or I'm doing this. So, I mean, I took all those things into consideration, but I also had to take into consideration I'm staying in Orlando. I'm not willing to go travel anywhere else. So if this is what's in Orlando, then
So, you know, when you go to a sporting event, especially a big major event, they'll have the military band there or whatever. Yeah. Like the guy, how do you become like a trumpet player in the military? Any idea? How does that work out?
I think you'd have to pick a job related to that.
To like trumpet playing. Yeah. So, I mean, were there any trumpet tiers available? No. Or no? Okay.
And that wouldn't be anything that I would.
Well, I'm just curious. Yeah. I've always wondered when they come out with the band, the military band. I don't know how you become a military band guy, you know? Can I be a drummer in the military? I've always wanted to be a drummer. Is that possible or no?
Oh, you can try. go to MEPS, see if they'll take you.
321-339-1055. Well, we will miss you temporarily. Yes. We still have a 2-month funeral to get to go yeah. through here. Aww. You know, maybe you shouldn't have told us till like early May or something, because now it feels like a 2-month sort of funeral, doesn't it? No, maybe not. Maybe no. It's a 2-month party. Like, we're excited for you. I don't know what
I
it
mean,
is.
I'm going to return, of course.
Yeah.
She's coming back.
But
it's just a matter of will you allow me.
So,
back.
Of course I will. So, we're going to have a going away party for Lurch. More details to follow. How soon before you leave should that party be? I mean, should it be a couple weeks before? Should it be right before? Because he probably wants to spend time with his family, Kayla.
Yeah.
Like that, you know, the week before or so. Do you think we should do, when should we do this going away party at Casey's in Lake Mary for his going away party? Let's look at the calendar here.
Yeah, so maybe do a.
You said May 18th,
yeah,
right?
May 18th.
May 18th is his departure day. What day of the week is that?
That is a Tuesday.
That's a Tuesday.
A Tuesday. So you probably won't be here that Monday, of course. Do you think you'll work through the week before or no?
Yeah, I mean, of course.
Likely?
Yeah.
Very likely?
Yeah, very likely, yes.
So
yeah,
maybe
Friday before?
So maybe that Friday before would be a perfect time for the 14th.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think? Is Eunice here or is she at work? Is Eunice listening?
She's at work right
now. Oh, never mind. So we could talk trash if we wanted to.
Yeah.
Oh. You know who hasn't? I haven't heard from Pilar on the text city. She must be very angry with me. She loves you. She must be super pissed.
Yeah, if she must say a
yeah. I mean,
what did you say? You got drunk on Sunday?
Oh,
what
no. She just texted me directly. She said, do Top Golf. That's a good idea. Except he doesn't drink or golf. So, I mean,
oh, no, man. I've been to Top Golf before.
Oh, yeah. What did you do? You don't know how to play golf, right? Did you swing the club?
Yes.
You
actually did? I swung, yes.
Oh, yeah. How'd it go for you?
Decent. Yeah.
Oh, he was playing against all girls.
Wow.
All right. So the party is going to be.
Top Golf's a good idea.
The party's on May 11th. Do you think we can lock that in or no? Or should we do a week before?
You said May 11th?
Yeah.
That's a Tuesday.
Well, what did you tell me? I'm sorry.
The
Friday.
If I'm leaving the 18th.
Yeah.
14th.
Yeah, let's do Friday the 14th.
May the 14th. Friday,
yeah,
May 14th. Okay. We're going to have a party. We're inviting you to come, of course. I'll buy. I'll buy. I'll even have it. I'll have it catered as well.
All right.
I'll buy and have it catered at Casey's in Lake Mary.
Shepherd's pie, like.
No. Oh, yeah, we could.
Let's
I guess
not.
So. No.
Shepherd's pie.
We're gonna have New York strips. Porterhouse.
No, right. No. I don't need any knives in that room with this group. You know. I mean, I'll do like tenderloin tips. Something we don't need knives for.
Don't worry.
I'm not getting full steaks with this crowd. Drunk? No way. You're out of your mind? What a horrible idea. You're not going to make it to the military.
Oh.
You're going to go with the scars, and they're going to be, oh, you didn't tell us about that scar. You didn't tell us about that scar at your AIT or whatever.
Right.
You know, back when you did your MPO.
Yeah, MEPS.
Oh, man. Let's hit some text messages, and then I'm going to tell you who got evicted from the White House.
Mm.
Actually, two evictions at the White House. Whoa! That's why we're running him out of here. He turns things up too high.
That's been the same as the whole show.
Maybe that was me. It could have been me. Scott is here. What's up, Scott? After party in Castleberry at 436 Finest Establishment.
Hey.
I know what you're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yes, he said yes. Oh, Fish wants us to do Taco Bell catering at Casey's. Yeah, that would be, you get right to his heart that way, Fish. You know how that goes. Sean said, count me in, and he'll bring the Tito's to Casey's in Lake Mary and High C for you.
Good.
Karen is here. Since they're going to elope, why don't we do a going away party and eloping party? I'll do that. Well, yeah, we'll do a little bit of a wedding party / eloping party for you guys.
All right. I like this idea.
Bill? Bill checks in. Congratulations, Lurch, from Full Metal Jacket, G.I. Go Boom Boom. Yeah, that's right. Henry is here. Lighten up, Francis. That's from Full Metal Jacket as well, I think. Cindy is here. Stay strong, Lurch. No boozing for you.
Yes.
Daryl checks in. Full Metal Jacket is my favorite military movie. I think mine too. I haven't seen it in a long time. It's disturbing, but it's
open
good.
Open your eyes, definitely.
It's disturbing, but good. All right. So you know the CDC is the Centers for Disease Control. We know that, correct? You even know that, right? They even talk about that on TikTok. They do.
And if not, Claudia Conway. You know.
Which I found very strange that the CDC is the one that instilled this eviction moratorium back. I believe they started this in September, maybe. It was originally extended through the end of January. And ultimately, there is now an eviction moratorium extended through the end of March. And really no sign of that being extended, and probably shouldn't be, because we have a lot of people who are our landlords right now who are not getting paid and can't get paid, yet they have to pay their own mortgage on the house. So I think that the end of March is a good stopping point for that. However, strangely enough, landlords right now cannot evict their tenants even if they're not getting paid rent, yet Joe Biden, your president, has evicted his two German shepherds from the White House. Ooh. Now, you might remember, right before he became president, we talked on this show about how many fluff pieces the media was going to do on him after bashing Trump for the longest time. And one of the biggest fluff pieces was that his German shepherd, the younger one, named Major Biden, was going to be the first ever rescue dog in the White House. Do you remember this fluff piece or no, Lurch?
Yes.
And they made a huge deal about it. They were doing stories left and right about how Joe Biden's this great guy. He rescued this dog, this German shepherd named Major. Major now evicted from the White House, sent back to Delaware. Here's what they
first
were talking about.
First dog elect. For the first time ever, a shelter dog is moving into the White House. He's a German shepherd. His name is Major. And Les Trent visited the shelter he used to call home before the Bidens adopted him.
After nearly four lonely years, dogs are returning to the White House. President-elect Biden will move.
You get the point, right? Yeah. There were so many stories about how Joe Biden was bringing this rescue dog to the White House, which is great. I think you should rescue dogs, too. I'm just saying I used it as a juxtaposition that Kayla's throwing me off there. Don't look at me when I'm trying to say long words, Kayla. You threw me off, and that's why I sound like an idiot right now.
You know the acronym?
A J-U-X to how the media covered Donald Trump. They were doing all of these hit pieces on Trump, yet they were doing pieces like this on Biden back when he was first inaugurated. But now they have shipped not just Major Biden, but their 13-year-old other German shepherd named Champ back to their house in Delaware. They adopted Major back in November 2018 from a Delaware animal shelter after it had what people are describing as a biting incident with a member of White House security.
Not biting incident. He bit the hell out of some.
Yeah, exactly. And they're shipping him right out of there. Major's 3 years old, and they say he's a little bit crazy around the White House, or has been. He displays agitated behavior, has done it many, many times, including jumping, barking, and charging at staff and security.
Oh,
the older Biden's German Shepherd Champ is about 13 years old.
Yeah, he's not doing anything.
And has slowed down physically due to his advanced age. I mean, these German Shepherds are pretty impressive dogs, wouldn't you say?
Yeah.
Very. Now, the thing is, if it's the dogs of the president of the United States.
Yeah.
Like, wouldn't you think they would have like a handler or someone like training?
Yeah. Or build a fence or something.
Training the dogs.
I'm shocked that they just let them ship them right out of there.
Not so much Champ, but for Major, like, okay, if the dog displays this kind of behavior, well, you know what? I'm the president of the United States. I'm
going
to bring someone in to be able to like train this dog so he acts more properly.
Absolutely. Yeah. They could even bring in that little short guy who had his TV show. What was his name? What was the dog trainer name? I haven't heard from him in a while. Did he have some sort of controversy, maybe?
Cesar Millan.
Cesar Millan. Yeah. Where's Cesar Millan? You're going to really ship him out of there? You're going to evict your dogs from the White House? Send them back to Delaware when you have Cesar Millan available?
So, I mean, like I said, they could have done a lot more.
Uh-oh. Someone getting attacked by a German shepherd, sir. Shouldn't run from the cops, bud.
Don't run from the police.
I don't want to get bit by one of those.
Yeah, neither do I.
Let's be honest, though. Do you think that when we support cops in the show. I love cops. I have a lot of cop friends. But do you think that when the cop pulls you over and the dog, they're like, we're going to get the dog. Do you think there's ever been a time when the dog hasn't smelled weed? You know what I'm saying?
No, they always
Because
smell.
They always will sit. And you can't even figure out what the dog does to make them think that there's drugs in there. Because they could either sit, they could scratch the car, whatever it is. And I'm also like, dude, what, your dog's like keying my car with the nails.
Yeah.
But I have never one time. No, it wasn't me getting attacked, guys.
Once they bring the dogs, that's
once
it.
They bring it's the dogs, the dogs are gonna smell. Yeah, they're gonna give them probable cause.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because I watch cops. I know how this stuff works. And live PD as well.
Live PD. Yeah.
I know how this works. Not one time in the 82 seasons of Cops did they ever call the sniffing dog over. Who didn't alert to drugs in the car. I think they're trained just to pretend to alert. And it was pretty smart policing.
Well, sir, I pulled you over because your taillights were out. I'm going to call in the canines.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Do you mind if we bring a dog over? Yeah, I do. But there's nothing you can do because I think the case law says if the dog alerts, it gives them probable cause to search your car.
Exactly. So as soon as the dog is, it's a done deal.
Everyone on text is accusing that of being me. Like, that's not me. Everyone's saying, was that you?
That's how you would be.
Maybe. I would already given up. Trust me, I would have my hands behind my back. I would have tattle told on my mother by this point if that's what it took. You know what I mean? Was your mom involved in that drug deal? Yes. Yeah. Absolutely. Sorry. That was Lurch. That was Lurch screaming. I don't mess with German shepherds, that's for sure.
Or any big dog.
I don't. Yeah.
any dog at all.
The dog has chased him into a dumpster. He's in a dumpster right now getting attacked. No, thank you.
But see, for Brocko, all I have to do is put some food on the table.
Oh,
and he's
Brock. My dog Brocko is not chasing anybody. Never gonna happen. Absolutely. Did you hear about the guy who shot his dog the other day? Terrible. This isn't Cocoa.
I didn't because I was at Tampa.
So this is in Cocoa, Florida. Not to be confused with Cocoa Beach. Close to each other, but quite different cities. Man in Cocoa took his dog to a park, tied him up. This was on Sunday, just a couple days ago. Took his dog to a park, tied him up to a pole, and shot his dog with a shotgun right there in a public park.
Heck?
Ironically enough, the park is called Brocko Pond Park, spelled just like my dog,
really?
Brocko. And they were like, why did you just shoot your dog in a park with a shotgun? He said, well, it tried to bite me and my girlfriend, so I took him from home to the park with the intent to kill it. What? Isn't there a better way than go to a public park?
Way better.
By no means am I saying do that. That obviously terrible thing, but why would you take him to a public park, number one? That's like mental disorder.
To shoot him.
To shoot your dog. He's in jail. They had to actually chase him down in his SUV. They saw him throw the shotgun like into the back seat. They found the shotgun. Hope he fries. Fry the guy.
What happened to the dog?
Had to euthanize it. Didn't survive. I mean, I guess it survived the shotgun blast.
But I mean, at that point, yeah. Good Lord.
That's so sad.
Terrible. What do we want to do next? I have too much to get to. I'm going to stay away from Meghan Markle today, I think. Mm-hmm. I think we'll hit her tomorrow. What do you think?
Yeah, because I haven't been able to read up on the story. Yeah.
Sean was attacked by a German shepherd. What?
Wow.
At the age of 6.
Oh,
So I babysat a German shepherd not too long ago. My buddy has a German shepherd and the dog, I mean, the dog was very active. I mean, let's put it that way.
I bet you were scared.
I wasn't scared, but she kept jumping up on, like jumping
exactly.
on my face in
like...
the bed. I was like, I thought we had at least some rules here. Like, don't jump on my face while I'm in bed. Right?
Yeah.
I think Shane has a German shepherd, doesn't he? Shane Reeve here. I'm almost positive he has a German Shepherd, too. The Morgan family loves German Shepherds. They're a little bit too, like, aggressive for me, I think. Aren't they? Or no? I know they're protectors, but... Oh, Franklin's been attacked 5 times.
Jesus.
Damn. I've been attacked 5 times in the past 4 years by large dogs. 2 of them I had to kill. No choice. What?
Wait, what?
Wait, what?
You're a stone cold killer.
You like boom boom kill? Like, really?
We need to get a story on that.
Franklin, you got to give us a little bit of insight on that, big boy. As a mail carrier, are you allowed to carry a weapon? You know, what do you think? I would think no.
But if they're the next branch of the U.S. military, then I guess.
Columbo said Lurch plus Eunice plus military equals the ultimate makeup sex when he returns. Oh, Dave the drummer is correcting me. I'm sorry, Dave. Lighten Up Francis was from Stripes, Bill Murray movie, not the Full Metal Jacket movie. Oh, Pilar does check in. Hello, Pilar. Congrats on joining, Fernando. So happy you get to do what you've always wanted to do, Heart. You'll be so missed while you're gone, and thank you for your service. Oh, that was sweet.
Wow.
Thank you. Thank you very much. All right, when we get back, CDC makes another appearance today. They tell us that 78% of people hospitalized from the virus suffered from what? 78% of the people hospitalized with the virus suffered from blank. I'll tell you that and much more. Quick break. It's Justin Clark on the Florida Man Radio Network.
You're listening to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark.
Oh, yeah. I dropped off my dry cleaning this morning. My good friends at 279 Cleaners take such good care of me. They will take care of you as well. In fact, if you told them that you heard it right here, tell them you heard it right here. They're going to give you the first garment absolutely free. Stop paying too much. There's no reason to overpay for dry cleaning when 279 Cleaners and my good buddy Wayne Stallman are right next door. Very convenient. Right down the street from the station, corner of Lake Avenue and 1792 in Maitland, right next to the Copper Rocket. Hey, no left turns. You can swing in, swing out. It's super easy. Stop paying too much. If you live anywhere in Orange or Seminole County, or work anywhere near Orange or Seminole County, there's no reason you don't want to switch over to 279 Cleaners. For me, the place I used to go was too expensive, but they kept losing my stuff. Not 279 Cleaners. Do me a favor. Call Wayne right now, 321-972-3661. First garment absolutely free, 279 Cleaners, 321-972-3661.
Florida Man Radio.
Previously on the Bubba the Love Sponge Show.
How long would you stay alive based on your BMI, and how long would I stay alive?
Well, I'd probably stay alive longer because ultimately I'd kill you and eat you.
Okay, but, Dan, we're not making it straight. Of course, we always got to make it a competition. Dan's always got to win. But what Dan doesn't realize is I always win because I'll just turn his mic off.
In the wild, you're going to turn his mic off?
Yeah, in the wild. Yeah, exactly.
Bubba the Love Sponge, morning 6 till 10 on Florida Man Radio.
Hey, man, your dog likes to hang out in downtown Sanford just as much as you do. Join Florida Man Radio at the 9th Annual Pints and Paws, Saturday, March 27th, on 2nd Street in downtown Sanford. Bring out your pup, family, and friends, or just your pup, and sample the best craft beers in Central Florida, local foods, live music, and tons of vendors for man's best friend. 100% of the proceeds at Pints and Paws benefits Dolly's Foundation and Pet Rescue by Judy. The 9th Annual Pints and Paws, Saturday, March 27th. For tickets and more info, log on to FloridaManRadio.com.
Skits Western Outfitters has been in the same location in downtown Osteen for 42 years. And Skips has the world's largest indoor Western city across from the Speedway in Daytona Beach. Bike Week is here. Get huge savings on the complete line of Durango boots during Skips' huge Bike Week Durango boot blowout sale. You'll find timeless and iconic Durango Western boots for men and women, work boots, and select motorcycle boots. Come into either Skips location and get a free gift with every Durango boot purchase. And during Skips' huge Bike Week blowout
out sale, register to win his and her pair of Durango boots. Get to the Bike Week Durango Boot Blowout Sale. Now at Skip's Western Outfitters in downtown Osteen on State Road 415 and Doyle Road, I-4 exit 108 just 7 miles east, or the world's largest indoor Western city in Daytona Beach in the Best Buy Plaza across from the Speedway. And at skipsboots.com.
It's all about attitude at Skip's. It's about.
Got a musty odor in your home? Visible stains in the ceiling? Mold around the windows and bathrooms? Are you showing symptoms of mold exposure, like watery eyes and itchy skin, headaches, coughing, and sneezing? Then you need to call the experts right now at Air Quality Assessors. 844-CALL-AQA. They'll provide indoor air quality testing, free in-home estimates. They'll deal with your insurance-related claims with no money out of pocket. Call anytime, 24 hours a day. 844-CALL-AQA. That's 844-225-5272. Or online at airqualityassessors.com.
Gentlemen, rev your hogs. It's Bike Week in Daytona. Ride on over here to experience Silhouette's Gentlemen's Club. Enjoy 30 of Central Florida's hottest and sexiest entertainers. Full bar service, big screens, great music, and private VIP options. Silhouette's has an awesome happy hour noon till 7, plus great drink specials every night. So come to Daytona for Bike Week and experience the hottest entertainers you've ever seen at Silhouette's Gentlemen's Club. Across from Volusia Top Gun, just west of I-95 on International Speedway Boulevard. Silhouette's.
Always get your go-to with the new $10 Tastemaker from Pizza Hut. A large pizza with up to three toppings for just $10. Choose contactless delivery or curbside pickup at pizzahut.com. Price higher in some locations. Limited time offer. Availability of contactless curbside and delivery areas. Charges and minimums vary. Delivery charge not tip.
Since 2016, medical cannabis has been legal in the state of Florida and available to qualified patients. Today, over 400,000 residents are able to legally purchase cannabis from medical marijuana treatment centers. At Trulieve, they strive to bring you the relief you need and a product you can trust. Their plants are hand-grown in an environment designed to reduce unwanted chemicals and pests, keeping the process natural. If you or someone you know can benefit by gaining access to medical cannabis, go to trueleave.com to find out how to get started.
What could you buy if you didn't have to pay a monthly power bill?
Go out to eat more often?
Take a vacation?
Get a new car? You could save thousands every year if you had free power. Get more info on the free power of the sun all year round by IQ Power Solar. Stop thinking about solar and let the sun power your water heater, warm your pool, or even power your entire home. Make sure you don't miss out on the 26% tax credit. Get a free estimate at IQPowerSolar.com. Click on service and submit your info or call 407-585-1018. Licensed and insured.
Have you thought of a career in real estate, or are you looking for a different way to grow and market your listings? You Have Realty is hiring and has opportunities for agents who can take advantage of our global approach to marketing. We can advertise your listings on TV, radio, and social media. Call 407-733-4700 for a confidential interview to discuss taking your career to the next level and the opportunity to work with our partner, Justin Clark.
Bubba the Love Sponge.
Hey, it's Bubba the Love Sponge. Listen every weekday mornings right here on Florida Man Radio, powered by Anajar and Levine, accident attorneys. Call 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
Get your fix of Florida Man Radio anytime and anywhere you are. Of course, you can catch Florida Man on 660 AM and 105.5 FM. But now you can listen wherever you are with the all-new Florida Man Radio app. And don't miss a second of the conversation at home by listening on your Alexa device. Just say, Alexa, play 105.5 Florida Man Radio. Florida Man is everywhere, unfiltered, unafraid. Get it how you need to, now.
Now, back to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark.
Apparently, Joe Biden's dogs got evicted from the White House. After all those fluff pieces they did on his pups before he was inaugurated there, now they've been evicted back in Delaware. I mean, who's watching them? I mean, Jill's at the White House, I presume, right? Mm-hmm. Who's watching the pups?
No one.
You think they're hanging out with Ted Cruz's poor dog by itself? They're all together, right?
They're going to band together.
But Franklin the mailman said he's been chased or bitten by two dogs as a mail carrier. Is this right?
Yeah, well, see, I've actually been attacked 5 different times.
Three of them
were non-lethal. They had grabbed either my pant leg or my jacket. Two of them were out for blood, and I had no choice but to kill them.
What? So what? Can mail carriers pack heat or not?
No, just unlike your wimpy butt, I actually use my hands to kill him.
What?
Whoa.
Hold up. Time out.
Yes.
So you, whoa. So you've been on your route delivering mail and attacked by, what kind of dog was kill number one?
Actually was a full grown 200 pound German Shepherd.
What? And so you, so the dog, okay, please, can I hear the story? You got to tell me.
All right, so the first dog was when I was actually a contract deliverer out of McDonough, Georgia. I was at an apartment complex, and this dog, it was actually on the second story of this four-story apartment, and it could see me every day I worked. And I was out there, and it was always barking at me, whatever. I didn't think much of it. Well, this one day, for some reason, it was very angry, and I was walking towards his building. He went through the panel glass of his back porch, was launching himself at me, jaws open, everything. And in midair, I don't know how I did it. Midair, I grabbed him by the collar, midair, and slammed him on the ground as hard as I could, and I snapped his neck.
What? What are you? Are you Davy Crockett or something?
Oh my God!
I did. Whoa! This dog comes flying at you. Is this BS? Is this legit? Be honest with me.
No, this is legit. And actually, the owner almost was going to call the cops on me, but when he looked at his back porch and saw the glass that the dog had blew through the glass and to come after me, he dropped the case.
So you grabbed the 200-pound dog midair by the neck and you snapped the neck and
by
that's
the
it?
Collar. By the collar. Yeah, and I used his momentum and slammed him on the concrete.
Damn. That's exactly how I would have responded too. Yeah, absolutely.
No, you would have been dead.
That's me running away. That's me running as fast as I can. I'm quite climbing a tree at this point.
Now, number two. I'm not allowed to carry a gun. Now, Amanda, she's hungry. That's what she's.
I understand.
But,
me too.
But no, the second dog. I was out in a rural area. This one actually when I was here in Locust Grove. This pit mix got out, snapped off his chain. Mm. Now see, I always carry a knife on me. I'm not supposed to carry a gun, but I carry a knife on me all the time. And this pit bull, he snapped his chain. He's talking. but this pit bull came after me. He got in the LLV. He was coming out. He had grabbed my leg, but he had grabbed the pants, not my actual leg, was trying to chomp down on me. In the position I was at, I could not grab him or to yank him off me. The only thing I could do was grab my knife, and I just started stabbing until he stopped.
Damn.
Well,
dang.
Yeah.
I don't know. Wow. That's crazy.
Ready,
I guess.
For basic training.
Yeah. Oh my God. Well, hey, stay safe out there, buddy. I don't know what else to say other than that's crazy. I'm not gonna carry mail anymore after all.
Oh, don't say anything about mail. Yeah. Mailman.
Oh jeez.
There was almost a third one, but he got smart and backed off. I had another dog break off a chain, come after me, and I started beating him over the head. With the scanner, and about the fifth hit, he finally kind of got the point that I wasn't scared of him, and he backed off, but he kind of walked away a little loopy.
All right, well, go be safe out there. Peace out. Why do I feel like Al the Mailman's about to call and totally discredit this entire story? Don't you? Al the Mailman is about to call or text saying, this is total BS. Maybe, possibly, he actually shot the dogs and doesn't want to admit that because he's not allowed to carry it in the LOV or whatever it's called. And why all these acronyms today? What is it? The mail carrier bus, the box thing, whatever, is it LOV, I think. What is it? LOV. But I think...
LLV.
LLV.
Yeah.
I think possibly maybe he shot two dogs, but doesn't want to admit that on the radio, And that's why he's saying, right, the one he said was flying through the air at 200 pounds, and he grabs it midair by the collar, and that's it. In one swoop, dead, got you. I don't know if I believe, I don't know. I love Franklin. Franklin, I love you, bud. However, according to our text messengers, your story's a bit suspect. Let's leave it at that.
Oh, God. UFC employees are prohibited.
Well, you know, Beanbag Nation doesn't oftentimes agree on anything. Beanbag Nation agrees on this one. Franklin might be a little bit off. Al, what do you think, buddy?
Well, I got bit by German Shepherd, but it was like a little bite mark. Mm-hmm. No big deal. Sprayed him a little bit. I think his story is a way far fetched.
A 200-pound German Shepherd flying through the air. He caught him one hand, bare hand, and boom, snapped his neck all at once. Well,
I think he's getting a sauce while he's working.
All right, brother. Have a good day.
I love you guys.
Love you too, man. Curtis the mailman. Curtis, what do you think, buddy?
Yeah, these other two mailmen are not real mailmen. See, the thing about the whole matter is they're liars. They're chronic liars. All they need to do is, you know, deliver the mail. But I got to tell you, Justin, I got one up on him.
What's up?
I killed a T-Rex. It came at me, left corner. I grabbed it by the collar, and I took it down. And a lot of people don't know the Smithsonian came out immediately and
right.
took the carcass with them, and I'm sticking with my store.
That's impressive and probably made a lot of money. I mean, the T-Rex bones are worth a lot of dough, I heard, so I'm sure you did quite well on that.
Hang on a minute, Justin. Sit down and say, I'm paying that ass. I know you're hungry. I'm tired of you.
Wow.
All right, Curtis. Have a good day, brother. Thanks for the call.
That was funny.
The Davy Crockett Show today. We grabbed German Shepherds flying through the air at 200 pounds, and we break their neck in one swoop to protect ourselves. Random J said Franklin also killed a leprechaun. It could be. Well, let's just say, I'm sorry I can't know all your text messages, but you're in agreement that maybe we don't believe the story. Believe the story. I love Franklin, but he's way off with the weight of a German Shepherd. Breed standard for males is 66 pounds. A 200-pound German Shepherd doesn't exist. It would be a Guinness World Record. All right. Lurch, thank you for your almost service.
Yes.
I'm sure we have two more months to talk about that. It'll be a good time. Good show today. What is it? Tuesday?
It's Tuesday.
There are three more days, and I'm going on a little vacation. A vacation that I'm going to do radio from, by the way, though. Kayla, excellent work today. We'd like to find out more about you. How do we do so?
It's GlitterX Cakes, Instagram.
Lurch, excellent job. Private Lurch, that is. More information can be found about you where?
Nando the Fern on Instagram, FernFMR on Twitter, and not taking down any dragons, T-Rexes, leprechauns, or any other mythical creature.
I'm swimming with the mermaids right after the show if you'd like to join me. Be happy to have you. I love you. I really do. Tell your friends. Make them download the app. Whatever it takes, please. We want them to join us as well. Do me a favor, though. Stick around. Because Bill O'Reilly is coming up next, followed by my good buddy and the legendary Edward Till from noon until 3 when Shando takes over. He's the anchor tenant, the Publix of this little radio station shopping center with the Shannon Burke Show for his good buddies, Yo Frey and DJ from 3 to 7. The party starts again tomorrow morning at 10 a.m. with my man Bubba, the Love Sponge. Kayla, I don't know much, but I do know one little teeny tiny thing.
And what is that?
I will see you right back here again tomorrow morning, 10 a.m. on the Florida Man Radio Network.